No need to wonder. God is real. Let's keep it real with points to ponder.
Hello, my friends. I'm Tyrone Hokum, and I'm the host who loves to bring you close. And of course, I'm talking about closer to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And the way that I'm able to do that is through this podcast, Points to Ponder. You know, I love to call it Your Points to Ponder. I'm so excited and delighted that you have decided to join in with me once again this week. I never take that for granted, and I mean it. I'm so thankful that I have brothers and sisters of precious like faith who knows that through all the turmoil in this world, we have a God to turn to. And so that's what motivates me to come with the Points to Ponder every week. And I know because you love the Lord and you look for the help of God, that's what compels you to tune into the Points to Ponder every week. And so without further ado, let me go into today's teaching. As a thought and a theme, I want to bring to you this particular title, Take Cover. And where we're coming from as it relates to in the Bible, I want to read for your hearing Exodus chapter 12, verses 3 through verse 5. And I want to read the New King James Version today. This is what it reads. Speak to all the congregation of Israel, saying, on the 10th of this month, every man shall take for himself a lamb, according to the house of his father, a lamb for a household. And if the household is too small for the lamb, let him and his neighbor next to his house take it according to the number of the persons, according to each man's need, you shall make your count for the lamb. And then finally, verse 5, your lamb shall be without blemish, a male of the first year. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. Now, I know I said a whole lot as I read that particular text from the Bible. But with all that I read, I really want us to hone in on one particular thing, and that is the lamb, and in particular, how it was brought out in Exodus chapter 12, I want you to take a mental note, and we'll, of course, go back and cover all three. But in this particular text, Exodus 12, verses 3 through 5, it points out that we should take a lamb. Then it tells us to take the lamb. And then finally, it tells us to take your lamb. And that is so critical if we're going to go through this life without worrying. There's so many reasons why we would have to worry in this world. But I'm here to tell you, the child of God, we never have to worry. Not if you consider the lamb. And if you don't know Jesus, then you got every reason to worry, because you don't have a lamb or the lamb, and you have not made him your lamb. And so in all of this, when I talk about take cover, what I'm conveying is that you are covered by Jesus. But even though you have covering, it's up to you and I to accept it, to take the cover. When we have the cover of the Lord, it's his assurance. And assurance is much different than insurance. There are three aspects that I want you to consider when it comes to God's assurance. Number one, man gives us insurance, but God gives assurance, which leads us now to the second aspect that we need to consider. That second aspect is you have to pay for insurance, but it's not so with assurance, because Jesus has already paid the price for you and I to have the coverage, to be under the canopy of God's assurance. But then the third aspect, and this is very vital for you to remember, and that is simply this: you can lose insurance due to a lapse of policy or an expiration in your policy or non-payment. However, I just conveyed in the second aspect that Jesus, he paid the price for our assurance. And because he paid the price for our assurance, then he has become the new covenant that we have with God. Now, a covenant is much different than a contract. See, insurance would fall up under a contract. But we don't have a contract with God. We have a covenant with God. And our new covenant is founded upon Jesus Christ. And when it's all said and done, we could never lose our policy or lose our coverage plan with God. Why? Because Jesus Christ will never expire. Jesus Christ will never die. He died the first time so that our sins could be removed. But now he'll never die again. He is the sinless Lamb of God forever. And so how do we take the lamb in the coverage that God has given unto us? Well, it's simply how Israel took the coverage thousands of years ago. They did what God called the Passover. And the Passover, what it really came down to was this: when Israel was in Egypt, and in the Bible, Egypt is always considered a type of the world that we live in. And when God's people, Israel, were in Egypt under Egyptian bondage, God came to deliver them. But God told them to go and get a lamb. Every family had to get a lamb and take the blood of the lamb and apply it to the doorposts of their homes. And when God's death angel went across entire Egypt, whoever had the blood of their lamb on the doorpost of their home, the death angel passed over that house. Coincidentally and consequently, all the firstborn children of Egypt, they died. But that was not the case with Israel. They experienced no deaths within the nation of Israel because they applied the blood of the lamb. Well, I say all of that to simply say this: you have to take cover. See, they had to apply the blood But what we have to do today is just receive the blood. Accept the blood. And when you accept the blood of Jesus Christ, now you are covered. And many of life's tragedies won't touch you. Now, it doesn't mean that we're going to go through this world problem free. Oh, no. But we won't have to worry, because many are the afflictions of the righteous. But I can bet you this, the Lord will deliver us from them all. And so we want to take cover. Now, when I talk about this particular text, I already shared with you that it's the Lamb that we want to focus on. And the Lamb is Jesus Christ. I hope that y'all are getting this. I hope that I'm not talking over your head. If I'm talking over your head, then lift your head up and just be encouraged, knowing that what I'm giving unto you, I'm not trying to give you a lot of information. Oh, no. But I want to bless you with this revelation. And that is, you have God's assurance that you are covered by God in this world's reign of trouble, of trials, of temptations, of tragedies. God wants to cover you and I. And the way that he does that is how we partake of the Lamb. Now, a Lamb is what we've read in verse 3. Let me read it for you again. Again, Exodus 12 and 3, the New King James Version. It reads, "On the 10th of this month, every man shall take for himself a lamb." When you take a lamb, that goes to say you recognize there's a problem. You see the problem. And what is the problem? The problem is simply, we need help. And I go on to even say this, we can't help ourselves. And so when you know you need help and you can't help yourself, then you can take whatever problem you have to the Lord. Some people, they have to undergo what is called intervention. And the reason why they have to undergo intervention is because they don't know they have a problem. I mean, if I'm talking about addicts in particular, if a person is addicted to any type of a drug or anything in life, it could be gambling, whatever the case may be. If they are addicted to something, they have a problem. But now intervention is needed when they don't know they have a problem. And so God, through this message, through this teaching, I believe it's divine intervention for many of us to understand that we have a problem, but we never have to focus on the problem, because in God, we have coverage. We have the answer, and that is Jesus Christ. And so we are to take the Lamb. I'm reminded of a time when my wife, Andrea, and I, we took a particular vacation to a resort. And when we arrived at the resort, it was in the evening time. And we were so spent in terms of physically. All we could do is order room service. And we ordered room service and remained in the room for the duration of the night. And I remember putting the do not disturb sign outside the room's door. And Andrea and I partook of our meal and went fast to sleep because we were so tired. Well, the next day we were revitalized. We had energy. And so we got up, we freshened up ourselves, and we immediately went out and hit the beach. And we spent the entire day out on the beach. And at that evening, we came back to our room to discover our room had not been cleaned. And so I made a phone call down to the front desk to complain that our room had not been cleaned. And they apologized and said they would send somebody up immediately. And I told them, well, it's nighttime. Wait till the next day. And so the next day, Andrea and I, we took out again to experience the town's different amenities and restaurants. And I was looking forward to getting back to the room again that evening. And when we came back again, the room had not been cleaned. This time I went to the front desk to issue my complaint. And when I got to the front desk, the clerk, he said to me, "Mr. Holcomb, we did try a couple of times to clean your room. However, every time we go up there, we've noticed that you have a do not disturb sign on the door, and it is our hotel's policy that we're not able to enter into the room if the do not disturb sign is on the door. And wow, I was amazed to hear that because it didn't dawn on me. I never removed the do not disturb sign from off the door. And I say that to say, many of God's people, they want God's help. They need God's help. However, they have a do not disturb sign over their heart and over their life. And therefore, whenever God tries to intervene, he's always turned away. I'm saying to you, my friends, remove the do not disturb sign from off of your life and allow God by his spirit and allow his angels to come and assist you as you need it. But now, to take cover, we have to take a lamb, but then we read over in verse 4 where it says we gotta take the lamb. So we progress from merely a lamb to the lamb. That is, we must get the right perspective. Let me read again, Exodus 12, verse 4 in the New King James Version. And if the household is too small for the lamb, let him and his neighbor next to his house take it according to the number of the persons, according to each man's need. You shall make your count for the lamb. It's so simple, we can miss it. How often have we read this text and we did not even realize the revelation that we have to move from a lamb, merely understanding we have a problem that we need a lamb, to now getting the right perspective in making a lamb the lamb. This is what John the Baptist declared. He says, "Behold, the Lamb of God that comes to take away the sins of the world." He used the term behold. In essence, he was trying to get his audience to see what was already there. And oftentimes, we can miss what's right in front of us if we're not looking with eyes of revelation. Many people say, "I don't see God." Well, let me tell you, oftentimes, people don't see God for the same reason criminals don't see the cops. They ain't looking for them. And so we have to look for God. We have to behold the Lamb. And that's what he told us. From the days of Moses to John the Baptist, Israel, they had sacrificed many lambs. And this is why John had to say, "Behold, not a lamb," because they had many lambs. But he said, "Behold, the Lamb." And therefore, we have to understand that we need the right perspective when we look at Jesus. He is the Lamb. Jesus, he said it this way, that he's the Alpha and the Omega. That's what the scriptures tell us. He is the Alpha and the Omega. He's the beginning and the end, the first and the last. But now let me park it on that title, the Alpha and the Omega, because I want us to have the right perspective about the Lamb. What does it mean that he is the Alpha and the Omega? Well, it means that he was the entire alphabet in the Hebrew system. Alpha was the first letter in the Hebrew alphabet, and Omega was the last letter in the Hebrew alphabet. So in essence, what Jesus was announcing and what the Bible was declaring is that he is the totality of the alphabet. He is all sufficient. Jesus is all that we need. It's like when you go to Amazon. I don't know if you ever really looked at the logo of Amazon, but the Amazon logo, it has an arrow that creates a smile. And that arrow, it goes from the A all the way over to the Z. And that's the company's way of saying, whatever you need, we have it all from A to Z. Well, that's what the Bible is declaring about Jesus, that whatever you need, he is all sufficient. You can get it from Jesus because he's the Alpha as well as the Omega. You know, whenever we receive Jesus, think about it this way. You get all of the Jesus that you're ever going to get. It's not like you get a little bit of Jesus when you first get saved, and the longer you're saved, you get more and more Jesus. No, you get Jesus in his totality, just like in our alphabet. Whenever we were taught our alphabet as little children, they didn't teach us a portion of the alphabet. No, they gave us the entire alphabet from A to Z. Now, when we were kids, we didn't know how to use the total alphabet. We just knew how to sing the alphabet. And then we knew how to spell words in three letters, in two letters with the alphabet, whether it was and or be or it. But the older we got, we understood more of the alphabet to the degree we knew now words made up sentences. And sentences put together comprised of paragraphs. And if you get enough paragraphs, you have a chapter. See, you got all the alphabet in the beginning, but the longer you used the alphabet, the more you got out of it and the more you knew how to use it. Well, so it is with Jesus, the Alpha and Omega. When you got saved, you got all of Jesus, but now you just need to know more about the Jesus that you have. He is the Lamb. But then finally, I love that it tells us in verse 5, your Lamb. That is, make it personal. Exodus 12, verse 5, again, the New King James Version, it reads, your Lamb shall be without blemish. My brothers and my sisters, all this scripture is telling us is you have to make Jesus personal in your life. Receive him in an intimate way. David made it personal when he declared, the Lord is my shepherd, so I shall not want. Paul, he seconded the notion and he made it personal as well. When Paul announced, and my God shall supply all your need according to his riches, in and through Christ Jesus. Do you know when Jesus came to this world and he introduced God to humanity, the biggest problem that Jesus had as it relates to the religious leaders of that day was he made God personal to God's people. Jesus, he would always call God, number one, his Father. But then he says, if you believe in me and receive me, then he will become your Father. On one occasion, Jesus told his disciples that when you pray, say, our Father, which art in heaven. And the religious leaders, they gave Jesus so much flack. They persecuted him because they thought of God as a distant deity. But Jesus was saying, no, God is your Father. Well, my brothers and my sisters, I want to ask you now, do you see him as your Lamb? Did you make him your personal Savior? If all you see Jesus is as a distant relative, then you will continue to worry. However, when you have that relationship with Jesus, and when you know that he is a friend who sticks closer than a brother, then all of your worry will burn under the fervent heat of your faith. I want you to know that you can progress. You can take cover in this world. And how do you take cover? Well, again, you have to progress. First and foremost, make Jesus and recognize Jesus as a Lamb. Get the Lamb, because you know, like I do, we will have problems. But then get the right perspective and make him the Lamb in your life. And finally, make him personal. Make God not just the God in heaven or the man upstairs, but see him as your Father, your caring, sharing, Heavenly Father. Make it personal and call Him your Lamb. I call Him my Lamb, and I have a personal relationship with God. And I'm convinced that because He is my God, that whatever afflictions I may undergo in life, He shall deliver me from them all. I'm hoping that after this message, you will take cover. And as you take cover, you can take courage, knowing that Jesus is your blessed assurance. Hallelujah. And you will never lose the assurance of God, because that covenant we have with Jesus is simply this: He will never die. So the policy will never expire. My friends, I pray that this message was a blessing unto you. And if it was, don't keep it to yourself. No, no, no. Please share this message with your family and with your friends. Let's get the algorithm of this particular message moving and get the numbers up. Get the views on YouTube up. I've done my part by teaching the message, and now I'm asking you to do your part by reaching out and giving this message to other people who will need to know they can take cover, knowing they have the blessed assurance of God provided through the Lamb of Jesus Christ. And then I'm asking you to get on with us with all of our different social media platforms, whether it's Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. I'm asking that you connect with us. And finally, above all things, until next week, if God shall tarry His coming, I want you to remain safe and remember, above all and everything else, God is real. God bless you. We love you.